diarrhea is different from, you know, infectious diarrhea. Okay, so we're talking about chlorid diarrhea, and one of the reasons for that is because of not trying to run away from your challenges, not taking responsibility for what you are dealing with. So I want to ask you, what does responsibility mean to you? You have seen the movie Spider-Man? There's a very famous dialogue in that: with great power comes great responsibility. And you have to ask yourself that if you are doing certain amount of work and somebody comes and says, do more, take more responsibility for something else, what is your immediate reaction? Are you a kind of person who's ready to take extra responsibility? Remember, the people who take that extra responsibility are the ones that who become the leaders. There are two kinds of people in this world. One is leader and one is follower. So if you are not ready to take responsibility, then you just end up being a follower. Make sense what I'm saying? So you have to look out for opportunities where you can take more responsibility. Okay? And what happens when, you know, our human nature is such that most of the time we keep blaming circumstances, people, whatever has happened around us. We keep saying that, oh, because of all this, today I have become like this. But there's another way of living. You can say that I will take responsibility for any decision that I make. And when you take responsibility for the outcome, for your results, then your circumstances will align to make those results happen. You will do whatever it takes to make that result happen. So in that way, you have a choice whether you want to live at the mercy of your circumstances or whether you want to take responsibility for yourself and the circumstances will align to what you have decided. Okay? Makes a lot of sense? So this is one tip for you to ponder when you, from now to the next class, look out for areas to take up new responsibility and build up this leadership quality in you. Okay? So this is the mental thinking about responsibility. Every week we will give you small tips like this. Okay? And Dr. Sharda,
so we discussed about constipation in the last two of our sessions. So since I talked about diarrhea as well, so to be clear about diarrhea, I'm going to talk more about that. Even though constipation and diarrhea are two opposite things, they usually coexist. In the sense, chronic diarrhea usually coexists with constipation. What is the reason for chronic diarrhea? It's usually stress. Chronic stress leads to all of the problems. So these are all psychosomatic.
The voice is still not very clear. Is it clear for everyone else, her voice?
Yeah, it's clear. Oh.
Yes, it's clear.
It is clear.
Okay. Yeah. So psychosomatic, psycho is in the mind, somatic is in the body. So most of the chronic ailments like IBS, irritable bowel syndrome, Crohn's disease, all of the problems related to the abdomen and the digestive system are at least 80% stress related. It's because we haven't taken care of ourselves. Being women, we are always, you know, taking care of others. When we are small, in our younger age, we are taking care of our younger siblings, or we're taking care of our parents. As we grow older, we get married, we take care of our husbands, and we take care of our children. Then again, we grow old, then we take care of our grandchildren. So we don't have time for ourselves. So we are neglecting ourselves, and our body takes the load. So that stress adds up little by little and little by little. And so this is a chronic kind of ailment, which can coexist as diarrhea and constipation. So how do you treat it? you don't have to worry about, oh, what is happening to my system, I'm totally going constipated and diarrhea, nothing. You just have to follow the simple principles I mention every time to you. That is drinking 2 to 3 liters of water daily. Some people say, oh, drinking water is not my thing, I just cannot do it. But what this is something which your body gets accustomed to. Now what happens is, if you are in the habit of drinking only water in the morning, then you will only feel thirsty in the morning. In the evening time, you're only looking for coffee or tea. What happens is you get dehydrated. As you get dehydrated, when you age, you get these eye bags, because your body is trying to hold on to water. Your body knows what you are, what is your habit. So what it tries to do something to compensate with your habit. So what it does is it holds water. So the one thing, the most important thing, is drinking ample amounts of water, at least 8 to 10 glasses of water. How do you recall that you have to drink water? Yes, you drink every hour 1 glass of water. 1 tall glass of water is more than sufficient every waking hour. If you do that, you're going to drink at least 10 to 12 glasses of water. I was telling about water and my son spilled water. Okay. So if you're drinking around 10 to 12 glasses of water, your body is going to be well hydrated. So when you're hydrated, your system, that is your respiratory system, because when you breathe out, you're putting in a lot of water outside. Because if you hold your hand or if you breathe against a mirror, you see there is so much of water vapor. You're losing a lot of water as you breathe out. So your lungs need a lot of water. For your circulation, your blood needs a lot of water, because 70 to 80% is all water in your body. For your digestion, you need water. For your elimination, you need water. What are we doing? We are not drinking enough water, and we are eating and trying to fill up our stomach. So the water, what requirement a body needs, we are trying to eat it up. So first stop that habit. That leads to obesity. It leads to all kinds of diseases. So first thing, when you feel hungry, first thing you do is drink, sip water. First is 1 glass of water. How you can do it is, like I said, every 1 hour, 1 glass of water. Then what you do is, before you brush 1 glass, after you brush 1 glass. So this becomes a habit. Before you go to shower, 1 glass of water. After you shower, 1 glass of water. And so that way, even if you're taking a hot shower, your body can compensate with the heat that you're going through. So your blood pressure doesn't go up and down. So that is one way you can compensate the water. Then make sure every day you take at least 1 vegetable juice. Ash gourd juice, carrot juice, beetroot juice. There's so many varieties. So get accustomed to drinking vegetable juices. And in the evening, when you're really bored or tired, you don't want to do all this kind of things, then you start drinking fruit juices. You can have pineapple juice. You can have so many options are there with the juices. So any of the juices you can drink. So then you have, you know, had enough amount of water. Another thing is, even if it's constipation or diarrhea, the first thing is your stools don't have bulk. When your stools don't have bulk, it either gets too dry and it cannot pass out, or it is too watery and then you get loose stools. So first thing is, you have to include enough amount of bulk in your stools. Avoid all white items like white rice, white sugar, maida, anything that looks white to you, which you know isn't good to you, you try to avoid it and compensate it with the real food, the wholesome, the red rice, the black rice. Even if you're eating soji, don't go for that Bombay white soji. Go for the traditional ones. Even though they may not taste initially good to you, but once you know you have passed your stools and your body is healthy, you will start to love it. Because that is where, why you're eating. You're eating not to eat. You're living not to eat. You're living to have a better life. So this is what the difference is. So having enough fiber, having enough water, and having enough of exercise. Because when you're in stress, your body is like this, you're holding on tight. You're like, you don't know that you're actually in stress. But when you start to do a neck movement, you start to release, because you cannot do neck movement holding on tight. So then you start to release, breathe in and breathe out. So that is why you need to do the exercise, so that your body recognizes unconsciously and you start to relax your body. And yoga is the best form of exercise for us is because yoga, after each pose, you have to relax. So that is the time when involuntary muscles, because all in our hands and legs have voluntary muscles, but inside our body, all our colon and everything that is inside our system is involuntary. We don't have control over it, but we do have control in our subconscious mind. So how do we train your subconscious mind? Is by doing meditation, by doing relaxation, by going early to bed and early to rise. All these ways you can actually relax unconsciously. So, and also including prebiotic, probiotics in your food. Pre and probiotics are like yogurt, then all fermented food, good fermented foods. You need to include that in your diet. So this is one thing. Then a lot of greens. And you have to make sure that triangle is there. So you have your carbohydrate, you have your protein, then you have your fats, and you have those essential vitamins and minerals. So that is a triangle you have to maintain. In case you are a little bit diabetic as well, then lessen the amount of carbohydrates. So don't go for, especially in Mangalore, we tend to love rice. So when we eat rice, because it is very much soft, it gets digested very quickly. So go for something which is hard, like go for chapatis, ragi in the night times, because there is a time when you don't have much exercise. So night times go for a little bit high fiber diet. So this way, not only thinking about constipation or diarrhea, if you think of your body as a whole and you treat, you will be treating all of your ailments. Actually, our body is very simple. It heals itself, provided you give it rest and ample amount of time for yourself. So that much, if you do like yoga, taking care of your food, water habits, all this, if you do, you'll be good to go. So I'll tell you a few treatments as well. In case you have diarrhea, what you can do is, this is the cold pack. I guess you have seen this one. So you have to fill cold water into this, maybe 1 or 2 glasses of water, and you can keep it in the refrigerator. Once it becomes cold, you can open it up like this. Then this, you keep it in this area over here, like this. And this cold water is going to lessen the amount of heat in the body. And so it will lessen the mobility of your intestines. So it's very good for diarrhea for you. And one other way, what you have to do is, you have your turkey towel like this. You fold it into half, fold it like this. And then this portion, this is a little bit bigger, no problem. You can dip it in cold water, then rinse it like this. Take the excess water. Then you lie down and keep it in the, this much you can do, and keep it in your stomach area, this area, like this. So from your, this to the pelvic region, if you cover it with the cold water for 20 minutes in empty stomach, this is a very good treatment to relax your colon, your abdomen, remove the excess heat, so that, you know, your body will heal itself. This treatment you could do every day to take care of your system. And you see, when you do that itself, your body will start to rest. You will feel, yes, I'm feeling better. But the only thing is, you'll feel lazy again the next day. So do not be lazy. Try to do this treatment every day, at least once. This is a very good treatment. So these two treatments, and in case you have a diarrhea, you could it could be infective diarrhea if it is an acute diarrhea, or if it is a chronic diarrhea, like I said, it could be because of stress, it could be because of prolonged illness, because of your taking tablets, medication for a long time. So you have to identify the root cause and try to fix it. But generally, like what I said, the drinking water, taking rest, doing yoga, all these treatments, whatever it is, infective or chronic, will help you. Then in case you have an infective diarrhea, try not to stop it with pills like loperamide, and all those pills are not good for you. They are going to stop the infection here, but that infection is going to multiply somewhere else. So try not to stop the diarrhea. Rather, you let that infection go out. Like you may get 2-3 times stools, but drink enough ample amount of water when you have diarrhea, and take like lemon juice with salt and honey. This is the thing you have to take care of. Then what you could do is, you could do a tea with decoction. take 2 glasses of water, put 1 spoon of tea, and into that you squeeze a lime. Then take this one. It is going to stop your diarrhea to a big extent. Even if it's an infective diarrhea, by 2 days, your body will start to heal itself and you will be okay. In case if it is something to do with really bad diarrhea, then you have to treat it. In 2 days, you know that you have to go to a doctor. Then you can go. But try to manage it by yourself. If you have blood in your stools, then you have to definitely go to the doctor. But otherwise, you know this is a common diarrhea. You can treat it yourself. All right. So we have another 20 minutes. We'll try to do some asanas with that. I would encourage all of you to do the yoga asana with me. I'll do simple asana. Rather than just looking at me, if you can do the practice, it is well and good. And today I will do at least 10 minutes of pranayam. So today we'll do 20 minutes of simple breathing, and then we'll do pranayam exercise. All right? Yes. So we'll come to the standing position. Krish!
We have 20 minutes left, huh?
Only 20 yeah. minutes left, right?
Huh? Yeah.
Okay. So shall I teach
the
pranayam today?
We'll do the asanas.
We'll do around 2 to 3. Okay.
You asanas and pranayam both.
Often poda. Often poda. I leave our meeting.
I wanted to keep it. Okay, can you see me?
Yeah, we can see you.
Okay. So we will do the loosening today. We'll do loosening and then we'll finish off with... So today my son is not helping me, so I'm trying to adjust. Yeah. So we'll do the loosening. So we'll start with the neck exercise. So keep a distance between your feet. Tie your hands behind. Now, in a relaxed manner, inhale and take your leg back. Exhale and bend forward. Inhale, look up. Exhale and bend forward. We do this 3 more times. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Don't forget to breathe in. Very good. Now we'll do to the right and left. Inhale to the right. Exhale to the left. So breathe in to your right. Breathe out to your left. So remember to go to the extreme right and extreme left. Again, inhale to your right. Exhale to your left. All right. Now we'll tilt our head. So tilt your head to the right and tilt to the left. Inhale to the right. Exhale to the left. Again. Inhale. Exhale. One last time. Inhale. Very good. Exhale. Okay, now we'll go on for the rotation. So the same thing, inhale to the right and up, exhale to the left and down. Inhale to the right, up, exhale, left and down. One last time to the right, up, exhale, left, down. Now we do anti-clockwise, left, up, right, down. Left, up, right, down. Last time. Left, up, right, down. Now close your eyes and just feel your neck muscles and your face muscles. Just feel the tension in your neck muscles, your shoulder muscles after performing these stretches. Now breathe into your face, neck and shoulders. And breathe out the tension. Once again, breathe into your face, neck, shoulders, and and breathe out. Now we will do the same, but while breathing out, we breathe out through the mouth with a slight curved lip like this. Breathe out like this, okay? So breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out the tension. One last time, breathe in and breathe out. You're feeling wonderful now. Now we'll go on to the hand exercises. So now we'll go on for rotation. Breathe in and breathe out. Clap behind like this. Breathe in. If you can, you can clap. Otherwise, you just take it behind. So two and three, four and five. Very good. Then we'll do forwards. One. So clap up if you can. Two. Three, breathe in, breathe out. Don't forget to breathe in, breathe out. Five, very good. Okay, so now we will do the swimming. One, alternate movement. Two, we'll do it 10 times. Three, four, five, breathe in, breathe out. Six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Very good. Now breathe out again. Breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in backwards, reverse. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Now if you feel any pain, you can just wiggle your hands like this. Relax your hands. Now we'll just stretch our spine. So extend your legs like this. Keep it up a bit far. And then inhale and raise. Exhale down. Inhale. Look up to the ceiling. Exhale down. Inhale, stretch, 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 exhale down. Inhale, stretch, stretch to the right, exhale down. Yeah, very good. Now we'll do forward and backward bending. So bend forward, one, two, three, bend forward. Now bend back, one, two, three. We'll repeat it three more times. Bend forward, one, two, three. Bend back, one, two, three. Forwards, one, two, three. Backwards, one, two, three. Very good. Now bring your legs together and sideward bend. Keep your hands straight, bend sideways. One, two, three, and one, two, three. Now, repeat it. One, two, three. Keep your knees straight. One, two, three. Shobha ma'am, your legs together. Legs together. One, two, three. Yes. Keep your legs together so you can feel maximum stretch on the sides of your body. Very good. Again. One, two, three. Now we'll do backward twist. Here you can keep your legs apart and twist. One, two, three. Come forward. Twist. One, two, three. Come forward. Inhale, twist. Exhale, front. Inhale, twist. Exhale, front. Twist. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Don't forget to breathe in and breathe out. Inhale. Very good. All right. Good to go. Now we'll go on to the hip rotation. Keep your hands in your hips and rotate. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Two more times. Inhale, exhale. Very good. Okay, now we'll go on to anti-clockwise. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Two more times. Yes, good going. Very good. So now your shoulders, neck, hips, spine is all stretched. We'll go on to the legs. So what you could do is, in case you have balance problems, you can take support. Otherwise, just try to touch your left toe with your right hand. Left toe with the right hand. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, good for your abdomen as well. 9 and 10. Now opposite. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Can take support in case it's hard. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good. Now we'll stretch our hip region. So inhale, out. 2, 3, 4. So rotation of your hips. 5. So inward to outward. Now outward to inward. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay, now do it on the opposite left leg. In to out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now out to in. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Good. Now we'll do the knee exercise. Keep your hands, bend at your knees, keep your hand on your knees and rotate. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then anticlockwise. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay. Now we'll do the kicking. 1, 2, 3. Bend at your knees and kick. 3, 4, 5. Then left leg. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Good. Now we'll do the ankle rotation. Clockwise. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Opposite. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, now breathe in and breathe out. Don't forget. Left leg. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Oh, sorry. Again, anti-clockwise. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right. So we've done with the loosening. Now we'll go on to the pranayama, breathing session. So take a comfortable position. You can sit down in a comfortable position. Okay, we have 10 more minutes to go, so we can do the breathing.
The first video on, please, if you can, so we can see who's there.
Yeah, you can turn on your videos. That's all right if
you don't want to, it's fine. Yeah.
So sit in any comfortable position. The first important thing is you need to make sure your spine is erect, because your lungs include this much of your portion. So this is the upper lobe, middle lobe, and the lower lobes. So if you are sitting like this, the lower lobes are going to be compressed and that area is not going to get enough air. So make sure you're sitting up upright, your neck, your shoulders, and your spine is nice and upright, and sit in this Jnana Mudra. Close your eyes and just follow your breath. Just observe without any interruption how the air flows into your nostrils and how it flows out. Just observe as an outside observer. Just observe how the air enters into your nostrils and how it goes out. Did you all feel it? Now, feel the temperature of the air that's entering into your nostrils. Feel the temperature.
Temperature.
cold or does it feel warm? So the feel the temperature of the air. Now feel the temperature of the air that's coming out of your nostrils. So usually the air that's entering is a little bit cooler because it's coming from the outside. And the air that's flowing out of your nostrils is warmer because it's warmed up by your body. So feel the temperature. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Very good. So now you are in touch with your breath. You can feel the temperature. You can feel how it's entering into your body. So now I'm going to teach the basic of pranayama, which is the sectional breathing. So here is going to be, as I said, three lobes of lungs, which is upper, middle, and the lower lobe. So now we are going to expand the lower lobe of our lung. So what you do is keep your right hand or your left hand, whichever, one hand on your abdomen and straighten up your spine. Now take a nice deep breath in and expand your stomach, the abdomen. Inhale and blow it up. Hold it there. One, two, three. Now exhale and suck your abdomen into your spine. Hold it there. One, two, three. Inhale, expand your abdomen. Exhale, retract. Inhale, expand, hold there. One, two, three. Exhale, hold it there. One, two, three. Very good. So now your lower lobes are expanded and contracted. Now we'll go on to the middle section of your lungs. So keep your hand on your chest. Now inhale and expand your chest. Inhale. Exhale and retract. Very good. Now we'll hold on for 3 seconds. Inhale. Hold it there. One, two, three. Exhale. Retract and hold it there. One, two, three. Once again, inhale, expand, expand, hold it there. One, two, three. Exhale and retract. Very good. Now hold it there. One, two, three. Good. Now we've done with the middle lobes. Now we'll go on to the upper lobes. So place your both hands on your shoulders like this. Place it on your shoulder. Make sure your spine is straight. Now inhale and expand your chest up to your ears. Inhale, exhale and down. Okay, again, inhale and expand your shoulders up to your ears. Hold it there. One, two, three. Exhale and down. One, two, three. Once again, inhale and up. Hold it there. One, two, three. Exhale and down. Hold it there. One, two, three. Now just go for chin mudra. Close your eyes and feel your lower lobes, middle lobe, and the upper lobe of your lungs. So how you felt when you did the abdomen breathing, how you felt when you did the chest breathing, and how you felt when you did the shoulder or the clavicular breathing. Just be aware of your chest region. You could go for deep breathing, inhaling and exhaling. Become one with your breath. One more time, deep breath. And breathe out. Excellent. You're already feeling wonderful. So now we'll go on to Brahmari. So what you have to do is plug your ears with the index finger. So you have to plug it, then take a deep breath in.
The Zoom might close anytime.
because it's already 6:40.
Yeah. So
you
chant Makara, like a humming bee. So inhale. Once again, inhale. It's a very relaxing sound. Just feel the vibration and relax within. Become one with your breath. Become one with yourself. If any thoughts do disturb, it's not important. Come back to your breath. Now, tie your hands behind your back and thank God for all the beautiful things that you have today in your life. So we'll bend forward and thank God. Inhale, come up. Very good. Now go for palming. Rub your hands. When you feel the heat in your hands, keep rubbing. When you feel the heat in your hands, cup them and place them over your eyes. Take a deep breath into your face. Exhale. Once again, inhale and exhale. Yes. So, hope you have understood the session. If you have any doubts, you can put it up in the WhatsApp group and I can take it up in the next session as well. So we have a limited session. I guess today we have more than 40 minutes, but I hope you all.
I don't know. And those who have joined in for the first time, I will add you to the Yoga with Smiles group. In case you don't want it, please let me know separately. Okay. Then I will not add you. Otherwise, you will get all the information in the Yoga with Smiles group. So can I have a nice smile from everybody, whether the video is on or not? I think we really enjoyed. Thank you, Dr. Sharda, your wonderful tips you gave regarding diet.